The topic is infinite line charge. Now, for this, we consider an infinite line situated on z-axis. Infinite line means length is of infinite length. Since this is an infinite line charge having a line charge density rho l, unit is coulomb per meter. This line charge is cylindrical in shape, so we assume a Gaussian surface to be a cylindrical in shape. So we consider a Gaussian surface of cylindrical in shape having a length L. Now on this Gaussian surface we consider a point P. P and the distance from with respect to z-axis is rho. So you don't make confusion between rho and rho L. Rho L is a line charge density and this rho is the distance of this point with respect to z-axis, or you can also say that rho is the radius of this assumed cylinder. Now at this point the electric flux density D is equals to D rho unit vector rho, because this electric flux density having a normal direction same as unit vector rho. Now the line charge density rho L is equals to Q upon L. So rho L into small l is the arbitrary length, assumed length of this Gaussian surface. So rho L into small l is equals to Q. Now we apply a Gauss's law. The capital Q is equals to surface, closed surface integration D dot ds. This ds vector also has a unit normal direction, that is towards unit vector rho. The dot product of these two vectors is d rho into ds. Since both vector has same direction, the dot product of same unit vector is 1. So we get only magnitude part. Now here is a closed surface integration of ds. Now we know that the surface area of the cylinder is 2 pi into radius into length, that is 2 pi rho L. This can also be calculated using differential length in case of cylindrical coordinate system. Now the differential surface in the direction of rho is rho into d phi into dz. Now here we use a integration with respect to phi and with respect to z. The limit of phi is 0 to 2 pi and the limit of z means height from 0 to L. After calculating we get 2 pi rho L, that is the surface area of the Gaussian surface. Now from here, after putting the value of capital Q, that is rho L into L, and using this, LL is cancelled and we get only d rho is equals to rho L upon 2 pi rho. Rho is the radius of the cylinder and rho L is the line charge density. Now this is the magnitude part. The back in terms of vector, we use a unit vector rho. So the surface integration of d dot ds evaluated on the top and bottom surface of the cylinder is 0, because at the top and bottom of the surface d has no z component. This means that at the top and bottom the vector D is tangential to that surface and the angle between them is 90 degree, and we get only rho component. Next is infinite sheet of charge. Now, due to this infinite sheet of charge, we calculate the electric flux density D by using the Gauss's law. Now, we first find the symmetry. Here it is infinite sheet of charge. So, we can assume a Gaussian surface. It may be a cylindrical type or rectangular type in three dimension. Infinite sheet of charge having a uniform charge density rho s. Its unit is coulomb per meter square. This infinite sheet of charge is situated on the z equals to 0 plane. Z equals to 0 plane means xy plane. Now, this assumed Gaussian surface, that is a rectangular box, has two parallel faces. Electric flow density D has no component along unit vector x and unit vector y. It has only z component. Because this sheet is situated on xy plane and its direction is towards z direction. So, the vector D is equals to dz unit vector z. And we know that the surface charge density rho s equals to q upon a is the area of top and bottom. And also we can write rho s equals to dq upon ds. Ds is a differential surface of this Gaussian surface. Ds is the differential surface on this infinite sheet of charge. Now, using the Gauss's law, q equals to integration d dot ds. The direction of d is towards z direction, and the direction of this vector ds is also towards z direction. So, the closed surface integration of d dot ds is equals to vector d has only z component and ds vector after calculating the closed surface integration. The closed assumed surface has three faces, top, bottom and this curved. The curved is towards x and y plane since it has no component. So, this part is zero surface, but the remaining part is the surface integration of the top and surface integration of the bottom, and we know that the surface area of top and bottom is capital A. We assume that the ds is differential surface area is A. Okay, now this q in terms of rho s is written as q equals to rho s into a. After calculating, we get a d component in direction of z equals to rho s upon 2. And in terms of vector, the vector d is equals to rho s upon 2 in the direction of z. We can also calculate the electric field density capital E, that is electric flow density D upon epsilon naught. It is equals to rho s upon 2 epsilon naught in the direction of z. Now the question is, if vector D is equals to 2y square plus z in the direction of x plus 4xy unit vector y plus x unit vector z coulomb per meter square. This is electric flow density D which is given. We have to find first the volume charge density at minus 103 and B part the flux through the cube defined by x greater equals to 0 less than equals to 1, y greater or equals to 0 less than or equals to 1, and z greater or equals to 0 less than or equals to 1, means x, y and z is represent a cube having a magnitude 1, 1, 1, means it is a unit cube. And third part is the total charge enclosed by this cube. First part is rho v. Rho v is the volume charge density. By using Maxwell's equation, it is equals to divergence of vector d. Now we apply a divergence of vector d. Del, that is del dot d. Del is a vector quantity and it is represented in this form d, and d is also given, which has x, y, which has unit vector x, y and z. After using this formula, we get rho v, that is 4 into x. Now the volume charge density at point -103, we simply put -1 in place of x and we get rho v equals to -4 coulomb per meter cube. The second part is we find the flux. So flux phi is equals to q enclosed by using a Gauss's law, and this q enclosed is nothing but a rho v into dv, volume integral, that is triple integral. Now rho v into dv. Dv is a differential volume and this is a Cartesian coordinate system. So dv in Cartesian is written as dx dy dz. So we take a triple integration with respect to x, y and z. The limit is same, 0 to 1. After calculating this integration, we get 2 coulomb. And the third part is the total charge enclosed by that cube. Now according to Gauss's law, the total charge enclosed is nothing but the total flux psi, and in B part we calculate the psi, that is 2 coulomb, that is same as q enclosed.